when there's an emergency call, the door goes up and the trucks go out. And we do everything we can to meet that mission goal. It's a lot easier when your workforce is safe, effective, and healthy.
The Hanover Fire EMS recently received a significant improvement award from the National Safety Council for their work in reducing injuries to employees.
And I have this very nice plaque that I want to present to them for all of the efforts that they've put together in reducing the number of injuries that they have on the job. They protect us. Protecting them is just as critical.
The award is a result of several initiatives and programs they have implemented over the last few years to not only reduce accidents and injuries, but to create a healthier workspace for their first responders.
The idea is once someone comes to work in this profession and it's identified as a cancer-causing profession, we want to take those individuals, and when they leave this profession, we want them to be in as good a shape, if not better, than when they started.
I now present you with the Hanover Fire EMS Tactical Fire Training Tower. You may cut the ribbon.
One initiative is the county's new Tactical Fire Training Tower.
So this project started in 2018 and has finally come to fruition. One of the most unique features about this building is that it is a gas-fed fire prop building. It is a Class B burn building, meaning we don't burn any wood products in here.
As individuals come into training over the course of their career, as well as being exposed to it in the field, you increase the number and the durations of their exposures from the time they start this profession until the time they leave. So if we had the opportunity to go with Class B as a fuel for our burn building, it limits the number and the duration of exposures in a training environment.
Another initiative is the installation of the Plymovent exhaust extraction system.
100% capture and release of the exhaust is what we wanted to go with, so we chose the Plymovent system.
The system hooks onto the vehicle exhaust by a magnet.
When it senses the pressure, it will kick the fan on and release the exhaust through an exterior vent pipe outside of the facility.
From the cancer prevention perspective, we've outfitted all of our members with two sets of firefighting PPE so that enables them to go to an emergency, return, and be able to decon and properly wash their gear. We've removed all of the socializing areas out of the bay areas to eliminate the need for folks being in and around the diesel exhaust.
The county also recently implemented the HAAS Alert System on their apparatus to mitigate accidents on the road.
So the HAAS Alert System is a GPS-enabled system that's activated from our emergency apparatus when our red lights are on. It sends a signal out to all motor vehicles that are using GPS-style navigation apps to alert them that we are in an area where we're operating an incident. Crews report saying they notice people start slowing down and moving over, observing the move over a lot more because they're getting that earlier warning.
The system also provides alerts when responders are about to cross paths with another emergency vehicle.
These lights will trigger when another HAAS-equipped vehicle is traveling along or near the same route that another vehicle is traveling. So it helps us in the event of blind curves or as we're approaching or navigating intersections with large commercial-style vehicles that we can't necessarily see around until we get up into the intersection.
Sheehan says all of these changes, training, and accident review have contributed to the reduction in injuries and incidents in the department.
When something happens, it's reviewed at different levels, not just operations, not just training, but also safety. So all three components have some buy-in or message to distribute to the department. So we raise the level of awareness and prevent the possibility of recurrence. If you can get an individual to have the agency and to be bought into the investment of their personal safety and their well-being over the course of their career, it's going to pay dividends when it comes to their longevity and the ability for them to work for us for a long period of time.
Risk manager Matt Phillips agrees.
Data tells us everything we need to know, and to see the amount of reductions in total worker injuries, total lost time days, total restricted duty days, and to see it in such a large chunk is very important. It tells me that we're headed in the right direction.
Throughout this process, Phillips has reached out to Versa safety consultant Fonda Craig for support and guidance.
I think the advantage from a Versa perspective is that we do as an organization have the ability to reach out and get good feedback when we need it to make good decisions and proactively reduce our risks.
And reducing risks, injuries, and incidents means they can focus on their mission. VRSA congratulates Hanover County Fire and EMS for their accomplishment at risk reduction. We are here to protect our members and their employees so they can effectively serve their communities. For more information on how your VRSA safety consultant can help you strengthen your risk management program, contact us today.